dinner party starter. I'm going to begin by putting a little bit of olive oil into a warm pan. I'm going to add some finely chopped shallot and garlic. And these just need to cook for a couple of minutes until they're softened. Once they're nice and tender, just turn off the heat and leave to cool. Now for the pastry, I'm using a block of puff pastry, and here is my salmon fillet. So use your salmon as a guide to how large to roll your pastry. So lightly flour the surface, pop your pastry on, and then just roll the pastry out evenly. The pastry needs to be twice as large as the salmon, plus a little bit of a border for crimping. As always, try and keep the pastry parallel to you and just turn it so you're rolling in the same direction all the time. And then once your pastry is large enough to enclose the salmon, you can stop rolling. Now I'm going to add some soft cheese to the shallots. You need about 75 grams, but for the full recipe, don't forget to click on the link below. Here I've got some lovely fragrant herbs. I've got tarragon, parsley and basil, and then some spinach that I've cooked and cooled. It's been roughly chopped. Just pop that into and give it a good mix together. There we go, and once that's well mixed, take half of the mixture and pop it on the lower half of the pastry. And then just with that spoon, I'm going to spread it out until it's roughly the same size as a piece of salmon. Make sure you leave a border along the edge for sealing the pastry. And then carefully take your piece of salmon and lay it on top. And we're going to cover it with the remaining mixture. And you don't need to be too fussy about it, but try and get it into an even layer if you can. And then make sure that your border is clear. And then with some beaten egg, just brush it all the way around the edges. And then just lift it towards you to enclose that salmon. Seal the edges and try and make sure that there are no air pockets left inside the parcel. And once it's nicely sealed, I'm just going to trim the edges a little bit just to neaten up our parcel. Same across the bottom. And then I've got a tray here that I've lined with parchment. Just carefully lift your parcel onto the tray. There we are. And then we're just going to crimp the edges. All the way around. Brush all over with that beaten egg. And you can chill this now until you're ready to bake. Otherwise, cook it for 25 minutes until puffed and golden brown and cooked all the way through. All you need to do then is slice and serve with salad or green vegetables. For more delicious recipes, don't forget to click to subscribe.